弟兄姊妹平安，今天是扎吉十六，扎吉管地沙主列，最近国际啊战聚的顶面对这个 COVID 这个破壁，战聚两仍然在破壁的中间，所以今天你虽然咱无法面对面做一个，但是我将这个圣经生活每一个阶段，特别面对这个困难的中间，这个圣经是以赛亚书第五十三章第四到第五节，请大家上帝的话。伊承认担当咱的忧患，背负咱的痛苦，咱却拿着伊受责罚，是乎上帝极不可待咯。那知影伊为咱的过犯受害，为咱的罪孽压上伊受的刑罚，咱得到平安。注意落尾一句话，因为伊受的鞭伤，咱得到医治。And by his wound, we are healed。上帝的是咪个？主要说的是咪个？为咱受的伤。目的是为得到医治咱的破病，所以咱破病的时阵有一条路通行，那是去找医生，找咱的上帝，伊是咱第一道的医生。我将今日准备交到主的手的中间，咱三个祈祷为着阮自己的主会交到主的内面，也是为着每一个家庭交到主的手中。咱三个阿头做一个祈祷，提拔阮来到你的头前，为着教会今日准备来祈祷来求恩。最近我听到真多真多家庭面对这个 COVID 这个破病，但是感谢上帝，因为耶稣为我们十字架的时候，不但是拯救我们的灵魂，也拯救我们的身躯，他受鞭伤让我们得到医治。当我们拖到破病的时候，我们来到你的头前，请求你家的祝福，你的同在和你的帮助，因为你是我们第一道的医生。祈祷君为着每一个教会、每一个兄弟姊妹、每一个家庭，交到主的手中，求你家己医治的手，临到君圣灵的中间，也将今日早起的敬拜交到主的手中，借着君所献受的圣事、献受的祈祷，为着传达上同样上帝的信息，好来敬拜属王上帝，将这荣耀颂赞拢交到主的手中，愿主的圣灵多领君早起的敬拜。关于这荣耀，各教导主的里面，感恩基督，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名 ，Amen and Amen。你知别人世界用音乐来阿罗敬拜咱的上。
Let me be a man with a perfect heart. Let me be a son who will please you, Father. Let me be a child who reveals your will in all I do and say. Fill me with your spirit, Lord, I pray, that Jesus will be seen in all of my life. Let me be a son who will please you, Father. Let me be a man with a perfect heart. Fill me with your spirit, Lord, I pray, that Jesus will be seen in all of my life. Let me be a son who will please you, Father. Let me be a man with a perfect heart. Let me be a son who will please you, Father. Let me be a man with a perfect heart.
In Matthew 11:28-30, Jesus says, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." In these verses, Jesus invites his followers to be renewed and find rest for their souls by coming to him. As a community of faith, let us come to God for renewal. This is why we gather together every quarter to participate in our 3-day church-wide reset. We do this to highlight the importance of prayer in the church's life as one body, collectively being strengthened and encouraged as a result. For this first reset of the year, we will have it on January 26-28, Wednesday to Friday, with the theme Renew. When the Bible speaks of renewal, it sometimes refers to the physical renewal, rest, required for our bodies to continue functioning at their best. God Himself instituted a day of rest for His people every week. And Psalms 23 speaks of a physical rest only God can provide. But rest and renewal are not only for our physical bodies, but also for our spiritual lives. Whenever we begin to tire spiritually, we should seek the Lord to strengthen and renew us, for it is His Spirit who will enable us and equip us to live for Him. When we lose our joy, we can pray and ask God to restore it. To be renewed means to experience the freshness of His presence in our spiritual lives and restored to a life of uninterrupted relationship with Him. A few reminders for this reason. First, we will be releasing prayer guides and reflections daily at 7 a.m. through our different social media platforms. Second, at 8 p.m. every night, we will gather online to pray as one body, as one church. Aside from praying for our families, church, and our nation, we will also be listening to different testimonies from our brothers and sisters and prayerfully respond through songs prepared by our worship teams. Our Pray As One nightly events build on each other, so be sure to attend all three nights. If you are limited in joining our online activities, a Reset Offline Primer containing reflection materials and prayer items will be available for you to download as the reset dates draw near. You can use this to participate even when offline. And finally, please note that ministry activities, life groups, and journey group meetings will be on break during the reset for us to devote our time and our energy to collective prayer. You know, my prayer is that we experience the Lord's renewal this reset as we participate in collective prayer and fasting. Let's carry each other's burden through prayer, strengthen one another, and collectively be renewed.
Peace, brothers and sisters. Let's resume our series, A New Humanity. Today, our topic is The Path to Harmony in the Home. A loving husband and a submissive wife. And our passage can be found in chapter 5, verses 22 to 23. In chapter 5, verse 21, there's a very important passage. It says, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. It's like a bridge. It connects both the personal and the community life. Those who want to submit to the Lord. Because they have a personal life. Because they want to glorify God. They will be willing to submit to one another. So in chapter 5, 22 to chapter 6, 9, it talks a lot about these interpersonal relationships. The relationship of a husband and a wife, a parent and a child, and a master and a servant. Today we'll talk about the husband and the wife. When God created Adam, God said it's not good for him to be alone. So from his ribs, he made a woman. When Adam saw Eve, he said, this is the bone of my bones, the flesh of my flesh. But later on, because they were tempted by the devil, they fell into sin, and sin destroyed that relationship. It destroyed the relationship between man and man. Now the relationship between husband and wife is one that bones that brittles against bones, and the malignancy in the flesh. And all of this comes from sin. In Genesis chapter 3:16, to the woman he said, I will make your pains in childbearing very severe.
with painful labor, you will give birth to children. Your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you. Because of sin, this is the punishment for
you.
You will desire for your husband, yet he will rule over you. When I read the Bible, when I first read the Bible, I said, you will desire for your husband. What is wrong with the statement? Why would the husband rule over the wife? It turns out the Hebrew word for desire has another meaning. If you look at chapter 4, verse 7, If you do what is right, will you not be accepted? But if you do not do what is right, sin is crouching at your door. It desires to have you, but you must rule over it. When God did not accept Cain's sacrifice, he was very angry. The Lord told him, you have to be careful. For sin is crouching at your door. It desires to have you. Not that sin loves you, but sin wants to control you.
So, when I was
So what Genesis 3:16 means is that the wife does not want to desire her as a husband, but she wants to control her husband. But the husband shall rule over the wife. So now the conflict between husband and wife began at home. But now we're a new creation. We're now living in the power of the Spirit. We should have a harmonious home. And our mean should be a loving husband and a submissive wife. Now from verses 22 to 33, we can see that it's divided into three parts. From 22 to 24, it addresses the wife. 25 to 32 addresses the husband. And 33 is for both. We can say that this is also a conclusion. Let's look at the first part. Which is the way of the wife. 22 to 24. In these three verses, it tells four things about submission. The reason, the object, and the scope, and the example of submission. So the first one. What is the reason for submission? From verses 22 to 23. Wives, submit to your own husbands as you do to the Lord, for the husband is the head of the wife. There's a reason for submission because the husband is the head of the wife. Before I mentioned that being the head means taking responsibility. The responsibility has been given to the husband. And the woman must respond in submission. Because he is her head. There is no animal that has two heads. And no human that has two heads. If someone has two heads, we call that person a monster. This is not normal. If a country has one head, it will not be archaic. If a person has one head, then the family will not be chaotic. So a ship has a captain. And a plane has a pilot. And even a car has a driver. And a school has a principal. And a family has parents. Ladies. Please remember that Adam was created first.
后来冲刺夏娃,
and Eve was created second.
所以等夏娃未出来的时候，亚当已经存在了。
So before Eve was created, Adam already existed.
所以上帝将这个责任交给亚当追头。
So God gave the responsibility of leadership to man.
指别人就顺服上帝安排。
And the women should submit to God's arrangement.
好了，第二呢？
The second.
顺服的对象。
The object of submission.
人顺服神啊。
Who should we submit to?
22节。
Verse 22.
你将天主的顺服嫁给丈夫，亲就顺服主。
Wives, submit yourselves to your own husbands as you do to the Lord.
亲就顺服主。
As you do to the Lord.
原来太太真正顺服对象是上帝。
The object of the wife's submission is to the Lord.
不是你的丈夫。
Not her husband.
我知道我这个丈夫是真刚果顺服。
I know there are some husbands that are hard to submit to.
因为这个丈夫要求我是真无理由的。
Because some of them are very unreasonable.
所以啊，你未结婚的以前啊。
So if you're still single.
特别啊，你都好快清楚你的男朋友了。
You should get to know your boyfriend well.
我教你一个真简单的秘诀。
Let me teach you a secret.
好观察了你的男朋友之后对伊父母。
Observe how the boyfriend treats his parents.
之后对伊的上司。
Those who is in authority.
之后对这个人有权柄的人。
Those who have authority.
因为这个人总是违反权柄的人。
If he's someone who opposes authority,
我跟你说，将来伊来追到你的头啊。
One day when he becomes your head,
你来做伊要听你讲话无？
Do you think he will listen to you?
无可能的代志。
No.
因为伊连家己头都唔会听落。
Because he would not even listen to his own head.
咁啊，最后听你讲话咧。
How else would he listen to you?
但是，
However,
你来结婚以后，
When you're married,
太太就顺服你家己丈夫咯。
Yeah. Wives, you know how to submit to your husband.
因为他是你的头咯,
because now he is your head.
那创世纪第36章头先咪所读嘅圣经。
In Genesis 3:16,
讲到就是太太爱控制丈夫啊。
It says that a wife wants to control his husband.
太太爱改变丈夫啊。
That she wants to change him.
但系太太啊， 你放手吧， give up 吧。
But wife, let it go.
你是无可能会能改变你的丈夫。
Because you cannot change your husband.
只有上帝能改变你。
Only God can change him.
我这个真出名的团队，人叫 Billy Graham.
There's a famous evangelist named Billy Graham.
他的太太叫 Ruth Graham.
His wife is named Ruth Graham.
这个 Ruth 顶摆不追一个见证。
She wants to share the testimony.
伊讲顶摆啊， 伊真用真多份爱改变伊 Billy Graham.
That back then she used a lot of effort to change her husband.
但是完全无成功。
But it was not successful.
你讲直到一日伊明白这项代志。
One day she understood.
原来上帝命令我是去帮助我的丈夫。
That God's command for me is to help my husband.
去顺服伊。
To submit.
不是去改变伊。
Not change.
你讲对待伊后。
From that day.
伊不要，伊爱做一个顺服个太太，无爱无要改变伊的丈夫。
She wants now submit to her husband and not change her husband.
但系奇妙发生。
But something amazing happened.
伊讲我看到 really 会改变。
She saw Billy's change.
姐妹,
ladies,
我当然唔望看到你嘅丈夫还是唔改变。
I hope that you will also see change in your husband.
但无论你怎样顺服，
no matter how you submit,
你嘅丈夫仍然冇改变。
If he does not still change,
你唔应该高兴。
Do not be sad.
因为你已经尽了亏了，做一个真正好嘅太太。
Because you have already done your responsibility as a good wife.
上帝的接纳你。
And the Lord will definitely accept you.
那你的丈夫呢?
And if your husband,
你交给上帝就好,
you shall entrust him to the Lord.
上帝必deal with你的丈夫。
And the Lord shall deal with him.
第三个字,
the third,
你讲顺服的范围,
the scope of submission.
你讲第九章二十四节,
let's look at chapter 5:24.
你讲交给之后顺服基督, 太太，之后还是顺服丈夫。
Now as a church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything.
In everything.
In everything.
还是顺服。
In everything.
你说，肯定我们说有没有搞错啊，什么弄错啊。
In Cantonese, how can this be possible?
每样都顺服。
Everything, submitting in everything.
但是呢，我们读圣经的人，都需要明白这样代志。
First of all, those who read the Bible should understand one thing.
当圣经讲还是的时候，
when the Bible says everything,
还是应该有这个范围的里面。
There is a scope.
这就保罗跟教会讲。
Just as Paul wrote to the church.
讲还是等下加，哎，
He says, everything is permissible, but not everything is beneficial. Everything is permissible, but not everything is constructive. Everything is permissible, but do not be controlled by anything. Everything here has a disclaimer. Do not violate the truth. Now, how should the church submit to Christ? Let's look at it from this angle. When Christ issued the command to the church, the church must submit. In the same way, when the wife has to submit to the husband, the wife must submit in everything. But think about it. Will Christ ask the church to submit in a way that goes against the truth?
Of course not. 这是不可能的事情.
No.
So he's saying, 当基督发出要求的时候,
so that when it says submit in everything, the scope is
这个是在真理的里面.
It must be in the truth.
所以当丈夫提出要求的时候,
so when a husband makes a request,
这个是在真理的里面.
It must be in the truth.
所以太太的信服是在真理的里面的信服.
So the wife must submit in everything in truth.
事实上,真罪太太无信服,不是因为无合真理.
Actually, many wives do not submit to their husbands because of the violation of the truth.
是因为我无爱,我无怀疑.
It's just because they don't want to.
我想感觉真空.
Sometimes they think this person is so stupid.
这个很空,给我听他讲话.
Why should I submit to someone who's so foolish?
姐妹啊,
sisters,
你感觉你的丈夫啦,真空.
If you think your husband is foolish,
但是你又嫁给他,
but you still married him,
请问谁更空?
Who then is more foolish?
是你更空呢? 还是他更空呢?
Is it you or him?
So
God help us.
当然，恁太太顺服丈夫，唔是棒都说yes啦，yes，yes，yes，唔是这个意思啦.
Of course, submission doesn't mean you have to say yes in everything.
因为太太是丈夫的好帮手啊.
Because a wife should be the helper of the husband.
所以太太应该帮衬丈夫做一个更好、更加对的决定.
So the wife should allow the husband to make even better decisions.
所以当丈夫发出要求的时候,
so when the husband requests,
虽然无违背了真理,
let's say it's not violating the truth,
但是
but it's not really a good decision either. Your responsibility as wife is very simple. You can suggest better ideas. It's not that you should be quiet, but be focused on this. The final decision still lies with the husband. But please focus. No matter whoever makes his decisions, he must bear the consequence. If the husband does not listen to your better idea, and there's a loss, and something bad happens, and if that thing happens, do not take this opportunity, wives, to berate your husband.
啊，看你这个戆人哦！
Look at you fool!
我早都跟你讲，我。I
have told you already.
你就是喺盾头级，冇得听出。
It's because you're stubborn.
最太太千万唔听你。
Do not say that.
你是个好嘅帮手。
You are a good helpmate.
你想安慰伊。
You should comfort him.
鼓励伊。
Encourage him.
千万唔当，同个人讲，乐尽杀事，这个石头听唔见字嚟。
Do not add insult to injury.
人已经。
The man has already fallen down. Yet you throw stones on
him. Golden opportunity.
Perhaps this is a golden opportunity. So that one day your husband will listen to you. In the future, when you share your opinion, he will listen. Because perhaps he would have learned his lesson. Another thing would be the example of submission. We can see this in 23 to 24. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body of which he is a savior.
Now, Paul
Paul uses the relationship of the church and Christ and the relationship between husband and wife. The husband is the head of the wife. Just as Christ is the head of the church. Also the savior of the church. When Paul said this, the church must submit to Christ.
So they do here.
To focus. After the we have become in Christ, a wife should submit to their husband's
identity.
What does it mean to be the savior of the church? You remember the story of the Garden of Gethsemane. The Lord prayed to God, the Father. He said, please take away this cup from me. This cup is his wrath. This is the cup of the cross. But God the Father said three things. Sorry, Jesus said three things. Not your will, but yours be done. We know that the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit are all equal. The Father is not greater than the Son. Nor is the Son greater than the Holy Spirit. All three are equal. However, look at 1 Corinthians
11:31.
But I want you to realize that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is man, and the head of Christ is God. Christ willingly submitted to the Father. He made the Father his head. And he followed the Father's plan. Even on the cross. Which he became the savior of the church.
So,
wife. Jesus Christ is the best example for submission.
We follow the example of Christ.
Following his example.
This is the way of the wife.
This is the way of the wife.
So, let's
talk about the husband. From verses
25
to
32.
This is the way of the husband. So, men, what do you feel about what I mentioned earlier? You must be thinking, the pastor has spoken very well. Women must submit. But men, do not be too happy. There are three verses addressed to the wife. But there are eight verses addressed to the husband. Almost three times. That is not easy. A husband must love their wife. And these eight verses tells us about four types of love.
无条件听，造就的听，听家己听，联合的听。
Love that is unconditional, that edifies, that loves as one loves himself, and it is united.
Look at
the first one.
那是用无条件听来听咱家己的太太。
An unconditional love.
你看第二十五节。Let's
look at verse 25.
你讲你最重要的，就听家己的太太，亲像基督听教会，为教会帮助家己。
Husbands, love your wives as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her. Christ loves the church. Is the church lovable? In John's writing in Revelations,
chapter 2 and 3,
2 and 3
7,
he wrote to seven churches. All five out of seven churches were rebuked by Jesus. Only two were not.
So it's about 70% of the
So Jesus was not happy with 70% of the churches. But he loved all them. Because his love for the church is unconditional. Marriage is two sinners living together. It is impossible to have no conflict at all.
对丈夫的人讲,
but God says to the husband,
丈夫, 听你自己的太太,
you should love your wife.
就亲求基督的教会,
just as Christ loved the church.
为教会帮助自己的心呀,
as he gave himself up for her.
不是教会可爱,
it's not because the church is lovable.
因为上帝听教会, unconditional.
But it's because Christ loved the church unconditionally. And your wife may not be lovable. But you should love her because she is your wife. Jimmy Carter, the 39th president of the United States. It is said that he is a very punctual person. If you're a punctual person, it's hard for you to tolerate those who are not. But unfortunately, Jimmy married Rosalyn, who is not very conscious of her time. Because she has to put on makeup before she leaves. So he has to wait for her.
So because
of her tardiness, they would also often go into arguments.
And
there was one year.
It
was Rosalyn's birthday.
And
Jimmy said to her, this year I will give you a special gift. From this year onwards, I will not get angry at you because I was waiting for you. And later on, there was a testimony by Rosalyn. Said from the year
1982,
that Jimmy has never lost his temper while waiting for
him.
He said, this is the best gift I have received.
Brothers,
I don't know what issue you have with your wife.
I don't know.
But you should accept it.
Unconditional love.
And you should love them unconditionally still. The second type of
love.
It's a love that builds up.
From verse 26
to 27.
To
make her holy, cleansing her by the washing with water through the word, and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any blemish, but holy and
blameless. Thank you.
When Eve was tempted by the devil,
and
she ate the fruit,
and
she gave Adam to eat,
in 1
Timothy, it tells us very clearly, it was not Adam who was deceived, but it was Eve. But when God came to the garden, who was he looking for?
Adam.
He was looking for Adam.
Adam, where are you?
He said, Adam, where are you? Shouldn't he be looking for Eve? But not.
Adam.
But he was looking for Adam. Because the first person that the Lord held responsible was not Eve, but Adam. Why is this? Because as a leader, he had that responsibility. He did not fulfill his responsibility as a leader. He should have guided, helped Eve. So that she'll be more mature against temptation. To be stronger. And this is a love that uplifts. Brothers. If you think there's something wrong with your wife, first ask yourself, have I done everything in my power to help her? Have I done my duty to build her up? It's easy to complain about others. Because our eyes are always pointed outwards.
So
children would complain about their parents. Husbands would complain about their parents. And the congregants would blame their pastors. It is true that we as people have many shortcomings. But if you have love, the situation would be different. Let's say we who are parents, we love our children. Sometimes when they do not do well, and they speak to us without any manners, but it's so easy for us to forgive them. Because we have a desire for them to grow. So Paul told the husbands, you should love your wives with a love that builds up. Don't just keep on complaining about them. But help them become blameless. And the third love is a love as one loves himself. In
528-30.
In the same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one has ever hated their own body. But they feed and care for their body, just as Christ does the church, for we are members of his body. Loving your wife is like loving your own body. A very simple truth. Because everybody knows how to love their own body. This is actually a very simple thing. If you're hungry, you would go eat. If you're thirsty, you would find something to drink.
It
is that simple. In Colossians, it adds one thing. It says, love your wives and do not be harsh with them.
So then, do you want to tear your gaggy tie?
As a husband, you must cherish your wife. Not treat them harshly. Pay attention to this. A husband must never beat his wife. If you have beaten your wife before, you must repent today.
I'm sorry.
And you must ask your wife to forgive you.
I'm not joking. This is a serious thing.
This is a very serious thing. A man must not beat his wife. You might say, oh, I have not hit my wife. But you may not beat your wife, but you may be verbally abusive.
Verbal abuse.
It's verbally abusive. This is also wrong. Some persons may not beat their wife or be verbally abusive, but they place all the burden of life upon her shoulders. Before you were married, you would immediately help your girlfriend carry their handbags. You're afraid that she might get tired. But after you're married, very
Wonder Woman.
Now your wife is a Wonder Woman. When you go to the supermarket, all the grocery bags is being carried by the wife. And only the man carries the car keys. This is also wrong. Do not put the burden upon your wife. So brothers, love your wife as you love yourself. The same way that you love your own body. Use that same love for your wife. But ask. Love that is united. from verses 31 to 32. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united with his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I am talking about Christ and the church. Paul is referring to Genesis
2:24.
That a man will leave his father and mother and be united with his wife.
这是创世纪二章二十七节.
This is in Genesis
chapter 2.
If leaving your parents is leaving, being united to your wife is cleaving. The purpose of leaving your parents is to be united with your wife.
而且这个世界哦, 除了 husband and wife, 没有这个关系, two become one.
There is no other relationship in the world wherein two becomes one, except for the husband and the wife.
我听我的囡仔,
I love my children.
但是我知道,
but I know
终于一天他们离开我,
one day they will leave us.
这是正常的,
this is normal.
因为我没要求哦,
I will not ask them to live with me after they're married.
应该有家庭,
if they have their own families.
那万一, in case.
In case.
他们离开我,
if they want to live with us.
我的家不差别,
I will not intervene with their daily matters. Their affairs will be their affairs. Your children is their children, not mine. I will not be meddling or busybody. We who are grandparents, do not meddle with the lives of your children and your grandchildren. This is being a busybody. This is no longer your affairs. We who are brothers should understand. When you're married, when you have been united with your wife, no one else should become closer.
对不住,包括你的爸爸,包括你的妈妈,
not even your parents.
That
their parents should not be closer to you than your
parents.
After, sometimes I hear people say, after he got married, he only cares for his wife and he has no longer have any mother. It's not that he does not have a mother. But the mother's role in his son's life must slowly diminish. But you're still their parents. And they still know that you are their parents. So do not say things that are not helpful. Some people would say that it is his wife that gave birth to him.
No.
You cannot say such things. This is not a helpful thing. We are Christians. We should speak words of encouragement. If you encourage your children, then they will love you even more.
Eventually,
if they know that you love them, then they will eventually love you back. May God help you. May God bless you. Last. In
5:33.
Each of you must love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Now this is for both of them. This could be the conclusion of this passage. Us who are husbands, you must love your wife. And the wife must respect her husband. This is an important principle. Women want to be loved, and men want to be respected. Husbands. You must love your wife. As husbands, you must understand that your wife wants to be loved. If your wife does not feel that she is loved, and if the husband does not feel that he is respected, this marriage will be in trouble.
So God help us.
May God help us. With the blessings of the Lord, let us begin this change. As wives, let us continue to respect our husbands. And husbands, love your wife. Only then the household will be harmonious. May God bless you. Bless your family and your marriage. Let us end in a prayer.
God bless you. Amen.